हेलो एवरीवन,
हेलो सर।
हेलो।
सो वेलकम टू टुडेज एंड वेरी फर्स्ट क्लास एंड सेशन ऑफ बेसिक्स ऑफ सिविल एंड मैकेनिकल इंजीनियरिंग क्लासेस। ओके, सो बिफोर आई स्टार्ट विथ एनीथिंग आई वुड लाइक टू इंट्रोड्यूस माई सेल्फ। ओके, सो माई सेल्फ मोहम्मद यासीन, आई एम फ्रॉम बीजापुर सिटी इन कर्नाटका। I have done my master's in concrete technology, M.Tech in concrete technology. Okay, so I'll be teaching you this subject, basics of civil engineering. Okay, actually the subject is basics of civil and mechanical engineering, but there is a different faculty for basics of mechanical engineering, and I'll be teaching you basics of civil engineering. Okay, so this is totally a one subject. For this one subject, there are two faculties. I am from civil department. Okay, I am from civil department. I'll be dealing with basics of civil engineering. Okay, so there will be another faculty who will be dealing with basics of mechanical engineering. Okay, so let me share you the syllabus of your subject. Okay, before we start with the subject, we should know what is there in our subject. Okay, what we are going to study in this and what is the objective of this subject. And we also should know that after completion of this subject, okay, after when we finish this subject, so what we will get to know and what are the things and what are the topics that we will get the knowledge of. Okay, so these things we should know before the start of subject. Okay, if you know what you are going to study in this subject, then you'll get interest to study. Okay, and you can compare yourself. So before the start of subject, if you get to know what we are going to study and after the completion, what are the things that you will learn. So while learning and at the end of the subject, you can compare yourself whether you have learned those topics or not. Okay, so that's why it is important to know what are the topics that you are going to study. I'll share you this syllabus copy on the screen. I hope it is visible to all of you.
Yes sir.
And I also hope that all of you have this syllabus copy with you. All of you are having with you, right?
Yes, sir.
Okay, then. So this is the syllabus copy. Faculty of Engineering and Technology. It is for all branches. Okay, so this is for all the branches. So in the first year, you know that you will be learning all the subjects of all the branches. Okay, here in the first year, you can get to know about other branches also. If you are from civil engineering, then you can get to know about mechanical engineering, then electrical engineering, computer science engineering, right? So you can get to know the knowledge of like just the basics of other branches also. So that's why in the first year, they have kept all the subjects. So here you can see these are the subjects you have in this first semester. So these are the things that you have. First subject is engineering physics or engineering chemistry. Depends on if you are learning physics in this semester, then it will be chemistry in the next. If you are learning chemistry here, then physics will be in the next semester. Okay, second subject is engineering mathematics 1. Then you have basics of civil and mechanical engineering. So this is the subject that I am going to teach you. Okay, so after that we have engineering mechanics, then universal human values and communication skills. Okay, so these are the six subjects that you have. Okay, so these are the six subjects you have in this semester. So in this all six subjects, I am going to teach you about half part of basics of civil and mechanical engineering. Okay, so because for this subject, as I told you, there are two faculties. So one will be dealing with the civil engineering and another will be dealing with the mechanical engineering. Okay, so as I am from the civil engineering department, so I'll be dealing with basics of civil engineering. Okay, then there will be basics of mechanical engineering also, for which you, there will be another person who will be teaching you. Okay, so in today's session we will see what is the subject and what is the introduction, what are the objectives and what are the outcomes of this subject. Okay, so these are the things that we'll see in today's session. Okay, then these are the labs that you have. Engineering physics or chemistry lab, or engineering mathematics, basics of civil and mechanical engineering, then engineering mechanics, communication skills, creative and design thinking, then workshop practice. So these are the labs that you have. And this is of second semester. Okay, here in this syllabus copy, these are the notations which will be used. If you see any of the notations like that, you have to understand which it refers to. If there is a L, okay, if there is a L written somewhere, it means that it indicates lecture. L indicates lecture. If you see T written somewhere, it means tutorial. P means lab session. Okay, you should remember this, because if you remember this, it will be easy for you to understand what it indicates. Okay, so for the lecture, it is like short form. L is the short form for lecture. T is the short form for tutorial. Then P is the short form for lab session. Likewise, FA is for formative assessment, SA for summative assessment, ESC for end semester examination, ISC for in semester examination, ICA for internal continuous assessment. Okay, so these are the notations which will be used. If you remember this, it will be easy for you to understand what it is indicating. Okay, so you should remember these notations. See, L is for lecture, T for tutorial, P for lab session. Okay, whereas if you see here, FA for formative assessment, summative assessment, ESC end semester examination, ISC in semester, ESC end semester examination, ISC in semester examination, and ICA for internal continuous assessment. Okay, so you might have understood this one. Okay, lecture, tutorial, lab session. So what do you mean by FA, SA, ISC, ESC and ICA? That I will tell you. Let us come to our subject now first. This is the syllabus of engineering physics. You'll get the syllabus of all the subjects here. This is of engineering chemistry. Engineering mathematics. Okay, here is our subject. Okay, basics of civil and mechanical engineering. Okay, so it is for first year BTech, all branches. Okay, so basics of civil and mechanical engineering. So before the name of subject, you can see here there is something written, C113. So C113 is the subject code. Okay, C113 is the subject code. Okay, remember that. Then in the teaching scheme, how is our teaching scheme? Theory, there will be 4 hours of lecture per week and it gives 4 credits. Okay, total number of theory subjects according to the this one university, we need to teach you 4 hours every week for this subject. Okay, but it will become difficult to complete the syllabus by taking only 4 lectures in a week. So there will be 6 lectures. Okay, we will be taking more lectures in order to complete the syllabus and in order to teach you in a better way. Okay, in order to teach you in a better way, we'll take more lectures. That is for civil engineering, I'll be taking 3 lectures in a week, and mechanical engineering, he'll be taking 3 lectures in a week. So 3 plus 3, it will be 6 lectures. But according to university guidelines, we need to take 4 hours. That is 2 plus 2. So here we are taking 3 plus 3. Okay, so to make you understand better and to teach you in a better manner, to give you some more and more information. Okay, so there will be 4 hours according to syllabus, 4 hours lectures in a week, then laboratory. Okay, lab, 2 hours per week. Okay, 2 hours per week there will be lab. Now coming to the examination scheme. Okay, so this was the teaching scheme. Okay, it was the teaching scheme. In the teaching scheme, we have 4 hours of lecture in a week and 2 hours of lab practice. Then in examination scheme, we have theory exam, that is ESC. It is of 70 marks. So what do you mean by ESC? Is there anyone who remembers what is the full
form?
End semester exam.
Good, very good. So ESC means end semester examination. So after the completion of this semester, okay, you will be having a university exam, right? So that university exam will be of 70 marks. Okay, university exam will be of 70 marks. Okay, so ISC is of 30 marks. What do you mean by ISC?
In semester exam.
Good. So ISC means in semester examination. Okay, so this will be of 30 marks. Okay, in semester examination will be of 30 marks. So during the semester, you will be having internals. Okay, during the semester, you will be having 3 internals. So each internal will be of 30 marks, and we will take the average of these 3 by dividing it by 3. How many marks you will get for 30 marks in the each internal? So there will be 3 internals. Okay, you will be having 3 internals, first internal, second internal, and third internal. Okay, so each internal will be of 30 marks. Then for first semester, first internal, second internal, and third internal, how many marks you will get? So you will add that and you will divide it by 3. So you will get the average of 3 internal exams. So that will be your marks out of 30. Okay, then ESC will be of 70 marks. Total it will be 100. Okay. Sorry, it is about ICA. ICA. What do you mean by ICA? ICA.
Internal continuous assessment.
Yes, internal continuous assessment. So this is internal, internal, not ISA. Okay, I just got confused. Okay, so this is about examination scheme. Now coming to the objectives, course objectives. So what are the course objectives? We will see. So as you know, our subject code is
C113.
Our subject code is C113, that you can see here. Okay. So if you see the first objective here, I'm going to tell you what are the course objectives. What do you mean by objective? Objective is nothing but what are the things that you are going to study. Okay, so what is your objective? You can ask any person what is your objective, right? So like that, what is the objective of this course? Means here you will get to know what you are going to study in this subject in the future. Okay, in the future days, what are the things that you are going to study? Okay, so our subject code is, so let us see the first objective. Our first subject code is C113. So that's why C113.01. Okay, C113 is the subject code. 0.01 is means it is first objective. Okay, 0.01 means our first objective. Okay, so what is the first objective? To acquaint students with the relevance of civil engineering for various applications in different branches of engineering and technology. Okay, so this is the first objective. To acquaint students with relevance of civil engineering for various applications. Okay, relevance of civil engineering for various applications in different branches of engineering and technology. Okay, it means that, so in this subject, you will get to know that the relationship between civil engineering and the other branches of the engineering and technology. Okay, in engineering and technology, you know, we have different branches. We have civil engineering, we have mechanical engineering, we have computer science engineering, right? You have electronics and telecommunication, and many, many others are there. Chemical engineering is there, and many branches are there. Okay, so these are the common branches and famous branches that I have told you. Still many more are there. Okay, so first objective of this subject to learn is that to make the students understand the relationship between civil engineering and other branches of engineering and technology. So other branches I told you, right? Mechanical engineering, computer science engineering, computer science is there, right? So other branches. So relationship between civil engineering and other branches of engineering. And what are the applications? Okay, so this is the first objective, to learn this subject. What is the second objective? C113.02. C113 is subject code, 02 is the second objective. To introduce students to environmental and water resource management. Okay, to introduce students to the environmental and water resource management, transportation engineering, various elements of buildings, concept of green buildings, remote sensing techniques, GIS and GPS. Okay, so this is the second objective. So let me explain you the second objective. If I just read it, you may not understand it. Okay, let me explain you. To introduce students to the environment and water resource management. Okay, so here in this subject, you are going to study the introduction related to environment. Okay, introduction related to environment. Environment also comes under civil engineering. Okay, environment, our whole environment, the study of environment comes under civil engineering. Okay, so here in this subject, we'll just see the introduction related to environment. Okay, so what is environment and all. Then we are going to study about water resources management. Okay, water resources management. What are the water resources we have? Can anybody tell me what are the different water resources we have? From where we get the water from nature?
Rain, river.
Yes.
Hand pump.
Lake.
Okay, good. Right? So you only told the answers. So these are the different water resources. We get the water from river, we get the water from borewell, we get the water from underground, right? So we get the water from lakes, we get the water from well, right? So these are the different water resources. Okay, so these are the different water resources. We will study the management of these water resources. How can we manage? How can we take the water? What is the procedure? Okay, so here we are going to study water resources management. Understood? Then we are going to study about transportation engineering. Okay, if I say transportation engineering, if you are from civil engineering branch, if suppose you are from civil engineering branch, then you see when you come to your branch, when you get a branch entry, at that time you will be having transportation engineering as a whole subject. It's a very vast field, transportation engineering. Okay, so there you will get to study about the roads, railways, tracks, and how you have to make the railways, roads, what should be the width of road, and different types of roads are there. Okay, so everything we will study in detail. So here in this subject, you will just have the introduction to transportation engineering. Understood? So when the vehicles are moving on the road, how much load will come on the road, what is the pressure will be created on the surface of road, how much strength of the road should be, right? So these are all things you will study in the transportation engineering, right? So here you'll be having only introduction about it. Okay, transportation engineering, then various elements of buildings. Okay, what are the different elements of building? If you see a building, okay, if you just see a building, what will be the different elements of that? What are the different parts of the building? Okay, you'll be having wall, you'll be having column, you'll be having beam, you'll be having slab, you'll be having floor, right? So these are the different elements of building, right? So we'll see the introduction to various elements of building. If you talk about types of buildings, you are having many types of buildings, right? You are having residential building. Residential building means where you stay, okay, as a home. Okay, as a home where you stay, that is called as residential. Then you are having commercial building. What do you mean by commercial building? Commercial building means
where you work.
Yes. Any other person who knows commercial building? Okay, commercial buildings means where you, as he said, work, or you can say it as which is used as a for business purpose. It can be anything which is, if it is a business related building, then it is a commercial building. Okay, so like function halls will be there. Okay, marriage function halls, then you'll be having a complex. Shops in the market. Okay, so those are the commercial buildings. Then you have public buildings. Okay, municipality office, any government office. Okay, so those are the public buildings. There where people will go to get their work done. Okay, so there are different types of buildings also. Then we have concepts of green buildings. So what do you mean by green building? Green, why it has given the name as green? We know nowadays how much pollution is there in the environment, right? Because of pollution, so many people are getting different diseases and they are getting died because of the environment. You know what will be the condition of Delhi in the winter season and all? How much pollution will be there and how much smog will be there? They will not be able to see what is there in the front. Okay, if there are vehicles which are moving on the road, okay, they can't see which vehicle is there in the front, right? So that much pollution and that much smog will be there. And these all are because of us only. Okay, we are producing a large amount of carbon dioxide. Okay, we are releasing a large amount of carbon dioxide in the environment, which is leading and which is affecting to our health, right? So that's why the concepts of green building came to picture. Okay, so here green building refers to the buildings which releases very minimum amount of carbon dioxide. Okay, you know how building release carbon dioxide? See, for the construction of building, okay, for the construction of building, you know we require cement. We require cement for the construction of building, if it is a RCC building or if it is a cement related building. So for the production of cement in the cement factory, okay, in the cement factory where the cement is manufactured, a huge amount of carbon dioxide will be released. Okay, a huge amount of carbon dioxide will be released from the cement factory. Okay, if you go and see the brick factory where they are manufacturing the bricks, you know they will burn it. Okay, they burn the bricks to produce the brick, right? So there also a huge amount of carbon dioxide will be released. Okay, or manufacturing of anything. Okay, if there is a release of carbon dioxide, it is affecting to environment. Now, the concept of green building is where you will use the materials. Okay, here you are using the materials which does not release carbon dioxide for its production or manufacture. Okay, so that to keep the environment safe. So that is called as green building. And also, you know, for if there is a building, we need light. Okay, electricity we need, right? At the night to light the rooms, to light the house, we need electricity, right? So that electricity comes from thermal power plants. Okay, if it is coming from thermal power plants, then you know in the thermal power plants also how much amount of carbon dioxide will be released. It is a huge amount, right? A huge amount of carbon dioxide will be released from the thermal power plants. If you are getting the electricity from wind turbines and all, so there it is, there is no effect of there is no effect to environment there, right? So green building refers to the buildings where you will require a minimum or no release of carbon dioxide for the building, even to light the building. Okay, so what you will do here usually in the green buildings, so you will produce your requirement of electricity in the building at the building itself. How? By putting a wind turbine on the building. Okay, you can do that for your home. If you don't want to purchase electricity from the government, make wind turbines. Okay, put it on your terrace of your building. So that also produces electricity. It can be used. Start it from one room. Okay, just for one room, you produce electricity which can light that particular room. One light from a wind turbine. See in the YouTube channels how to prepare a wind turbine, a small wind turbine. Make a wind turbine to keep the environment safe. Start it from your own house for one room. Then you will get the knowledge how to make it, how to produce more electricity. Then you make it two wind turbines, or otherwise make a bigger wind turbine. Okay, so green building means to keep the environment safe. By keeping the safety of environment in mind, you will construct a building, and that building will not be having any effect on the environment. Okay, so that is the concept of green building. So we will study about green building in this subject. Okay, then next is remote sensing techniques, GIS and GPS. So this is all about second objective. Okay, so this is about second objective. Okay, so here, in the second objective, we are going to study about remote sensing techniques, GIS, GPS. I think all of you know what is GPS. Everybody will be having it in their mobile, GPS, to track the location, to see the distance between one place to another place, right? So GPS, so you might be knowing about it, right? So everybody knows about it. Now, our third objective, C113.03. What it? So, to introduce basic streams of mechanical engineering, such as design engineering, production engineering, and thermal engineering. Then C113.04, to make the students identify different mechanical engineering applications in day-to-day life. Okay, so C113.03 and C113.04, third and fourth objective is related to basics of mechanical engineering. Okay, so the faculty who is teaching you mechanical engineering will explain you that. Okay, so this is all about course objectives. Okay, there are four course objectives in basics of civil and mechanical engineering. So in which first two objectives are related to basics of civil engineering, which I have explained you. Okay, third and fourth is related to mechanical engineering. Okay, so this is about course objectives. There are course outcomes also that we will see in the next class. So you please ask me if you have any kind of a question related to course objective or related to, if you have any kind of a doubt related to anything, you can ask me. Or if you want any modification in the way I am teaching, or if you are not understanding the language, what I am speaking, you can tell me. Or if you want any changes in my teaching method or in the delivering of lecture.
No, sir.
Okay. How many of you are able to understand my language and my teaching? Please say yes if you are understanding.
Yes, sir.
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 Okay. Please raise your hands. Okay, there is an option there. Please raise your hands if you are understanding my language and teaching. Let me see how many of you are. Because if you say yes, I will not get to know who is telling and how many of you are telling. So if you raise your hands, I will get to know how many number of students are understanding and who is understanding. Good. Other students? Around 4 or 5 students are remaining still out of 32 students. Okay, thank you. Thank you so much. Okay, so no doubt you people are understanding my language and the way I'm teaching. But still, if you want any correction to be done, or if you want anything that that you need in me, you please tell me. Or if you want me to explain in any other language, or this English is enough for you, even you can tell me that also. You be frank to tell anything.
Sir Anderson.
Okay. So fine, I'll continue in my future lectures also in this language only, the same tone, same voice, same language. Okay, so I don't think there is any thing to be changed, right?
Hindi use kar sakte
hai? Haan, main Hindi mein bhi padha sakta hoon. Do you want me to explain in Hindi also in between?
Yes, sir.
How many of you?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Please, all of you, down your hands, then raise it again to see, to let me see how many of you want me to explain in Hindi also. Marathi. So one of your friend is asking me to explain in Marathi also, but so let me tell you that I don't know Marathi. Either I can explain you in English or Hindi. So most of the teaching will be in English only, because English is mandatory. I must explain you in English, but in between, to make you better understand, I will tell Hindi. Okay, so that is not 100% Hindi, means around 80 to 90% will be English only. So in between, somewhat I'll speak Hindi.
Yes sir. Okay.
Okay sir. Okay.
Okay sir. Okay sir.
Good. You are active people. Okay. Abhi, okay. What are the things I taught you to in today's session? Can anybody tell me? मैंने आज के क्लास में क्या क्या पढ़ाया, क्या कोई मुझे बोल सकता है कि मैंने क्या क्या पढ़ाया आज के क्लास में?
Four courses objectives.
Okay.
Hello.
हाँ बोलो.
Examination scheme and course objectives.
फिर क्या बोला मैंने आज की क्लास में?
Environment.
Various applications of civil engineering in all different branches of engineering and technologies.
Okay. Any other person?
Pollution.
Course objectives.
Course objectives. Then anybody else? You be active. You can unmute yourself. You can be frank with me. You can tell me anything. Okay. Related to subject only.
Concept of green building.
Yes. Or kuch?
Identifying different mechanical engineering applications.
Or?
Transportation engineering.
ट्रांसपोर्टेशन इंजीनियरिंग में क्या बताया मैंने?
रोड्स, रेलवे रूल्स.
ओके, और क्या बताया?
If a car going on a road, how much pressure will be on a road?
Yes. If any vehicle is moving on the road, how much pressure it will create on the surface of road when it is moving, right? Okay. तुमने तो सब बता दिया, सिर्फ ये नहीं बताया कि मैंने अपना introduction भी बोला था starting में.
हाँ sir.
Okay. ठीक है. I will take your attendance. Okay, I will take your attendance. Then we will end up the session here. In the next session,
sir.
Yes.
What is remote sensing technique?
Remote sensing technique. If I tell you now, you may not understand it better. So that's why I didn't explain you like I explained other topics. Okay. Remote sensing. We will see when it comes to the topic. Okay, when we are studying the subject, at that time we will understand it better.
Okay.
So remote sensing will be related to sensors. Okay, so usually when we are moving on a sea in the ships, they use remote sensing and all. So you may not understand it better if I explain you in some 1 or 2 minutes. So that's why I didn't take much time to tell you about it. Okay. I'll just call the names of the participants. Okay, if you are present, say you are present. Okay, so then only your attendance will be counted. I'll call out the names. If you are present, say yes.